Greetings. This is another reason to reject Islam. Reason number 6. The Allah of Islam is a liar. What exactly does that even mean, Texas? If you try and take the Quran at face value, the message it presents damns itself. Okay, I'll slow down and present this in unassailable detail. The foundation of the Quran is the claim that it is a message from the deity called Allah. Assume for the moment, for the sake of argument, this claim is true. Let's assume the claims in the Quran are actual facts. And let's examine the first and most damning problem the Quran creates for itself. Sura 4:157. I already have a video or two about the contradiction between this and Sura 5:14. The problem I am speaking of here is not the contradiction, but the implication of the Sura. The claim of Sura 4:157 is that Jesus was not killed on the cross. He was not even crucified. Allah only made it appear to be so. And that is the damning problem, my friend. The implication of this damning claim by the Quran cannot be overstated. The implication of the Quran is that Allah deceived all who witnessed the crucifixion. Let's be a little more blunt and direct. According to the Quran, Allah lied. That is the only conclusion from the implication that Allah deceived all of mankind. Allah lied. Allah did not let even one man see that Jesus was raised up to heaven. Not even the men the Quran calls faithful Muslims, the disciples of Jesus. Surah 352. But when Jesus became conscious of their disbelief, he cried, "Who will be my helpers in the cause of Allah?" And the disciples said, "We will be Allah's helpers. We believe in Allah, and bear thou witness that we have surrendered unto him." We will be Allah's helpers. We believe in Allah, and bear witness that we have surrendered. So according to the Quran, the disciples were sworn Muslims. Think about that. And still, Allah deceived them. Think about that and let it sink in. According to the Quran, Allah lied to Muslims who swore their oaths to him. Allah cannot be trusted. O Muslim, if Allah would lie his head off to the very men who loved and followed Issa, he will lie to anyone and everyone. But this is a critical fact you must learn, O Muslim. The Allah of Islam, who lies to all men and all mankind, is not the God of Abraham, Jehovah, Hashem. This is the damning implication of the claim of Surah 4:157. Allah lied to faithful Muslims who loved Issa. If Allah lied to the apostles, Allah will lie to you. In fact, the Allah of Islam has already lied to you. The demon that called itself Allah, that scared Mohammed in the cave, was not God. The demon lied. Go figure. And because the spirit that gave the Quran was a lying demon, I reject Islam. Now, if you call yourself Muslim so you can please this liar, I have some questions for you. What proof do you have of anything Muhammad claimed he heard from this liar? If Allah made it appear to be so and deceived Issa's disciples for 600 years, How do you know Allah did not deceive you about the claim of the night journey, the claim of the moon splitting, the claim of Muhammad in the cave, the claim Allah gave something to Jibreel, even the claim this spirit calling itself Allah is really God? What evidence do you have from this liar? Do you not know that once a liar is proven to be a liar, nothing he says is trustworthy? Well, the implication of Surah 4157 is that Allah is a proven liar. You are putting your faith in a proven liar. I think you want to be sincere, O Muslim, but I also know that your Allah is a liar. In fact, the liar is so convinced you cannot see past his lies, he mocks you. Satan mocks you and admits he is the best deceiver. He is trusting that his lies are too good for you to see through. Well, is he right? Do you value the truth enough to examine his lies? Or will you believe the lies like a trusting child? Feel free to post your comments, O Muslim. Do you believe the lies of Allah? Because the Quran teaches Allah is a liar. It is simply impossible for you Mohammedans to come up with a story to excuse Allah's lying. So I reject Islam, the Quran, and the Allah it describes. And I suggest you too reject the liar and his lying message. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.